Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Anna Clauren. Good morning, Anna.
Yes, good morning. The southwest monsoon is still prevailing over southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao, and this will bring cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Quezon, Mimaropa, Bicol region, the whole Visayas, and Mindanao. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon, we're expecting a generally fair weather condition this morning up until the late noon. But in the afternoon or evening, expect rain showers or isolated rain showers or thunderstorms due to habagat and localized thunderstorms. And currently, we're not monitoring any weather disturbance that may affect the country for the next 3 to 5 days. The temperature range here in Metro Manila will be around 25 to 33 degrees Celsius. In Baguio City, 18 to 26 degrees, and in Tagaytay, 23 to 31 degrees Celsius. And that's the latest for PAGASA. This is Anna Clauren. Good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Anna. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urged to convene the National Security Council to address China's illegal actions in the West Philippine Sea. Senate Majority Leader Francis Tolentino says the NSC should be advising the president on the next steps of the government. For Tolentino, the escalation was revolting given the severe injuries suffered by Filipino troops, including a sailor who lost his thumb.
Kailangan na to kasi involved na yung peace and security ng ating bansa, and to have the National Security Council be convened would show that we are really in a heightened level, not just of awareness but of a possible national response. Isa-isang tabi natin yung mga political considerations. Siguro ang mananay dito, ang mangingibaw dito, yung dapat maging appropriate response at yung pangangailangan ng bansa.
Asked if the Mutual Defense Treaty with the U.S. should already be invoked, Tolentino said it will still have to be studied.
It boils down to the definition of a quote-unquote armed attack. Is it an attack that would involve the use of large-scale violence, utilizing weaponry, yung mga baril, kanyon, that threatens the security of the state, or pwede na lang yung pwede bang i-consider na armed attack yung na-deflate yung isang vessel natin, natanggalan ng, although talagang nakakasuklam yung natanggalan tayo ng isang daliri, yung ating isang sundalo. Yes. So yung definition siguro ng armed attack pursuant to that Mutual Defense Treaty would have to be studied first. At siguro ito yung dapat iaral ng National Security Council.
Meanwhile, Senate President Francis Escudero said the upper chamber wants a full briefing from the Foreign Affairs Department on what he described as the alarming encounter between Manila and Beijing. He also urged the DFA to go beyond the filing of diplomatic protests. The Philippine Armed Forces reveals the extent of damage caused by China's harassment in Ayungin Shoal. Aside from puncturing the Navy's rubber boat, the Chinese Coast Guard also destroyed the windshield, as well as the communications and navigational equipment of another Navy vessel. Personal phones of some troops were also damaged following the confrontation. Even the Philippine Coast Guard vessel that rescued Filipino troops, including the soldier who lost his finger, was also not spared from China's harassment. Following the incident, the Philippines vows to prepare more for a possible escalation.
Okay. What we could do is to prepare our men, equip them appropriately. If you notice, may mismatch. Yung ating men, we abide by the rules. Yung ginagawa nila, pamingirata, pambabastos, pangbarbaric. They have no right to wear the uniform. Coast Guardsmen are supposed to be responsible for safety of life at sea. Their actions endanger life at sea.
China not budging on its own narrative despite glaring proof of its aggression. Beijing's foreign ministry claims it is Manila that should immediately stop its provocation in the West Philippine Sea. It also accuses the Philippines of distorting the truth of the recent encounter in Ayungin Shoal. Beijing claims China has the right to take necessary measures to safeguard its perceived sovereignty in areas which legally belong to the Philippines. The Philippine government confirms the sinking of the ill-fated MV Tudor vessel attacked by the Houthis last week. The Migrant Workers Department says the bulk carrier was last seen on June 17, a day before salvaging operations were supposed to happen. Despite this, government holds on to hope the missing Filipino seafarer, believed to have been trapped in the ship's engine room, is still alive.
We, of course, immediately communicated with the next of kin of our missing seafarer on board the ship. And we had been in touch and assured them of our continuing support and assistance. We cannot officially confirm his death or his passing. He is missing. We will never let go in terms of standing beside the family during these difficult times.
The MV Tudor is the second commercial vessel sunk by the Houthi militant group since March. The Liberal Party rejecting pronouncements of Vice President Sara Duterte will now be an opposition leader following her resignation from the Marcos cabinet. Joyce Balancho tells us more.
Following Vice President Sara Duterte's resignation from the administration's cabinet, speculation surfaced as to what her next political moves will be. One of her allies, Attorney Harry Roque, says her cabinet exit means the uni-team tandem of Marcos and Duterte is already dismantled, and described the vice president as the leader of the opposition. But the Liberal Party quickly rebuts Roque's declaration, saying that the foundation of the true opposition lies on accountability, transparency, and concern for the public welfare, qualities which they believe are not present in VP Duterte's track record. Liberal Party President and Albay Congressman Edsel Lagman asserts they are the true opposition.
Sa ngayon, sapagkat incompatible ang amin na ideological principles, ay mahirap magsabi na bukas ang pinto para kay Sara Duterte. There is no ideological affinity between the Liberal Party and Vice President Sara Duterte.
Even the Makabayan Bloc refuses to acknowledge VP Sara as the opposition leader.
Saan banda? Katulad na nga dun sa PUV modernization, wala siyang sinasabi dyan at niredtag pa nga kami, no? Kaugnay dyan. At ano ba talaga yung tunay na oposisyon?
Meron ba siyang tinitindigan na independent foreign policy? Kasi kung yung mga tindig niya dito, pareho lang din naman sa mga tindig ng kasalukuyang administrasyon, hindi siya tunay na oposisyon.
Senator Loren Legarda also doubts VP Duterte will take on this role.
I don't want to speculate because even the reasons behind the resignation are beyond me because it was not mentioned. So, is there an opposition? We thrive in a democracy, and to have a robust, healthy opposition that is constructive is good for a democracy.
Political analyst Attorney Michael Yusinko believes the declaration should come from Duterte herself if she is indeed stepping up to be the opposition leader.
Because it is a responsibility, it's a job. That means she's going to have to face the administration head on. One-on-one battle, not just with President Marcos, but with his allies, with his team, with his surrogates. So, malaking ano yon, malaking impact yon for her as a politician.
Yusinko adds, Duterte's no comment on national issues cannot be interpreted as indication that she will join the opposition.
I think she was being deferential and respectful to President Marcos, no? Being part of the cabinet. Right? Kaya nga I said, kahit man lang mga underhanded and subtle side remarks man lang, at least yon pwede natin pang hawakan na, oh, baka meron siyang iniisip na maging opposition leader. But the complete silence can only be explained by being respectful to where she is, no, being part of the administration.
When Vice President Duterte addressed the public Wednesday afternoon, she did not mention her reasons for resigning nor her next political plans. Meanwhile, former presidential spokesperson Salvador Panelo, who is an ally of the vice president, believes Duterte will be a huge loss for the Marcos administration. Panelo adds, the resignation will pave the way for new political alliances in a different political ballgame. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
At least one senator is calling on President Marcos to issue his position on POGOs in his upcoming State of the Nation address next month. Senator Loren Legarda says the country is better off without the POGO industry.
I would welcome that. Yes. If there could be a clear stand on the closure of this dance of criminal syndicates masquerading as online gaming, but actually involved in sex trafficking, human trafficking, kidnapping. Do we want that on our shores? Do we want that in our backyards? No. Ito ay bantana sa pamumuhay ng mga Pilipinong namumuhay ng tahimik sa ating bansa.
Legarda, a party member of the Nationalist People's Coalition, also wants Bamban Mayor Alice Go expelled from the party. The town mayor has been linked to illegal POGOs operations and is facing questions over her citizenship.